welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time here, I'm Charlotte and I build homes in Accra, Ghana. Today, I'm taking you guys through all the foundation works for Project Red Room, which is a four-bedroom all-en-suite with 4.5 baths, open living and kitchen space, a kitchenette that comes with a pantry, a laundry and storage room, a rooftop terrace that comes with the office and utility area. This building is being constructed on clay soil, and at the end of the video, you'd see how we were able to execute the foundation works effectively. First off, we started by setting out, which is basically transferring the dimensions and layouts of the structure from the architectural drawings onto the ground. And we've opted to use a total station, which is a high-tech tool that combines measuring angles and distances. So this method is easier and precise when positioning structural elements. Prior to that, we determined the concrete level by conducting a survey of the site to establish the existing ground level and the required finish level. This helps understand the topography of the land and helps in planning the construction process. So we did that, and we used the automatic level to measure the desired height and to ensure that the floor levels align with the architectural plans. So as you can see in the video, that's when the points were being taken and the steel benders working on the side. What you see now is the soil test being done. So for expansive soils like clay, you have to ensure that you get your structural engineer and the technical engineer on site. And from the geotechnical reports, we were required to go 1.4 meter deep, and you can see that there is a change in soil property at that 1.4 meter and it is more stable. So that's about 4.5 feet deep. For trenches, we went 3 feet. You can see the excavated material being disposed of. We took about 9 trips off site. And over here, we laid the DPM. This is the 500 microns, which is higher than the 300, and we opted for the best. After we casted a 50mm blinding and we marked the position to ensure accuracy. So the formwork for the column bases began. So those are the pictures. If column bases are important and they provide stable connection between the column and the foundation, and also helps distribute the loads from the column to the foundation evenly. Some people do not do it. I do not know why. So that is when the steel works were going on, and always ensure that your rings are hooked at 135 degrees as to 90 degrees that can easily open. So after casting the column bases, we painted them with bitumen, which acts as a barrier against water penetration. We tried to keep the foundation as dry as possible, leaving no stone unturned. So we have DPM under. We paint it. We want that extra protection. So there you have it. And from here, we went straight to working on the foundation beams. Foundation beams provide stability and support, and it also reduces the damage of expansion and contraction of the soil. So it provides a solid base for this foundation. And as you can see, the formwork is being done, and we placed DPMs everywhere. The beams, the column bases, everywhere to prevent water from rising through the foundation. Building in clay can be quite expensive when done properly, but will save you a lot of money and stress in the future. So do not cut corners when it comes to construction. Do it and do it once. So this is how the foundation looked after. Now the block work starts, and after laying the block work, we casted the columns. Always ensure you have enough rod length coming from your foundation to ensure proper lapping. Short rod length can lead to weak connections. After we got our filling to site, and then painted the block internally and externally with bitumen. This protects the foundation from water seepage, which can cause dampness, molds, weakening of foundation walls, and also prevents water ingress. After painting, this is how the foundation looked like, and we went straight to filling. So this is grade one filling, which is best for filling foundation. And after, we went straight to compaction. So we used the roller plates to compact the soil. And essentially what compaction does is to reduce the air voids and increase the soil density, which improves the load-bearing capacity of the foundation. So always add water, which acts as a good binding agent and makes compaction relatively easier. So with water, you have better compaction. The plumber goes straight to work and lay the pipes according to the architectural drawings. Always ensure that that is being done. Shout outs to my plumber. He's the best plumber in Ghana. As you can see from the video, he placed chippings around his pipes. This is to maintain the stability around the soil. I always advise clients to go for smaller chippings because they improve the consistency of the concrete mixture and reduce the risk of honeycombing in the finished structure. After, we got to laying rods all over the DPC laid on the floor. Most structural designs come with BRC mesh to reinforce the concrete and to prevent cracking. But since we were on a tight schedule, we decided to kill two birds with one stone. We designed the oversized concrete as if it were a suspended one. So by doing this, we placed the rebars 500 mm from the bottom to increase the load-bearing capacity of the foundation and to protect the foundation in the case where there is settlement. So after laying the rods, we came in again and then we used the automatic level to pick levels to ensure that we have the same concrete thickness all around the building. And we did this prior to casting, but I do not have footages of that. And we always ensure that we use the right mix ratios as indicated in the structural drawings and also add mixtures to improve the strength of the concrete. You can see one of the guys already seated on the concrete because of the fast drying properties of the admixture. So that's it for today. And if you learned something from the video, then please like, comment and share so others can see this video. That way the algorithm will pick it up and share it to other people as well. Kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't and turn on the notification bell to always get notified each time I post. Thank you and see you on the next one. Bye. Enjoy the rest of the video.